In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you always.
And with your
spirit. Lord Jesus, teacher of the law, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ Jesus, bearer of mercy. Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, Prince of Peace, Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Almighty ever living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command, so that we may make what you promise. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Children to come forward for children's liturgy of the word.
So good to have all of you here with us today to listen to the children's word.
And as you go out, you will ask God to open your hearts to listen, to learn, and to bring back what you learned to your parents and all around you. So go forward and listen to the Word.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know what sort of people we were among you for your sake, and you became imitators of us and of the Lord, receiving the word in great affliction, with joy from the Holy Spirit, so that you became a model for all the believers in Macedonia and Achaia. From you the word of the Lord has sounded forth, not only in Macedonia and in Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has gone forth, so that we have no need to sing. For they themselves openly declare about us what sort of reception we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve the living and true God, and to await his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who delivers us from the coming wrath. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
And there was a struggle probably at that time. This wasn't probably just a test, but it was probably a discussion that was going on all the time with all the scholars. What is it that we should focus on? What we find out is that first commandment, that first thing that Jesus brought forward, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and all your mind, is first because everything should flow from that. We know the Ten Commandments. The first three are, I am the Lord your God, you shall worship the Lord your God, and Him only shall you serve. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain, and remember to keep holy the Sabbath day. All of these are focused on building that relationship with God and holding that close and letting Him lead us. St. Thomas tells us that that is the most important, and while that second commandment, love your neighbor as yourself, is a commandment that is extremely important. But he says a person who genuinely loves God also loves his fellows because he realizes they are his brothers and sisters, children of the same Father. But he also mentions that, however, if we love for man's sake without reference to God, this love will become an obstacle in the way of keeping the first commandment and keeping our focus on that. So what does that mean? Well, I think, you know, in today's culture, we can almost say we may go with a focus on that second commandment, love your neighbor as yourself. So what that means today for many is that we want to show love, but we don't want to ever upset anyone. What my dad would say is he would say, and I can remember this so many times because I wasn't always a good kid when I was growing up. He would say, this hurts me more than it hurts you, and by golly, you need it. So, you know, one of the things we have to keep in mind is when we are touching others, we don't judge. But when we see them going wayward, it is love for them, and that love is coming from God, to help guide them to what a greater calling God may have for each of them. And that's the same for us. At times we may have friends or someone that may gently prod us and push us along. And we hope that that is coming through this first commandment, where love is, where God is guiding us with our love to help our neighbors. I think it's also really good to kind of focus on that first reading from Exodus. You know, he talks about the widows, the aliens, the strangers from abroad, the orphans. Because in that day, that was the lowest of the low. When you became a widow, you basically had nothing. Same for the orphans. And strangers coming from abroad, they may just be having clothes on their body and that's all they have. So our focus in that reading kind of leads us towards the material help, which is a great foundation for what we do. We are called to that kind of help. But I think also St. Paul's letter to the Thessalonians can guide us as well towards help on that spiritual side. Because sometimes we focus so much on that material help that we can't remember to address the spiritual side. And we may have many opportunities when we give help for that to open someone to helping move them along their path to God. So we read in St. Paul's letter to the Thessalonians about how that faith is growing. St. Paul is so happy to see how the faith has spread. And he talks about how the apostles imitated Christ, and people saw how they lived and what they said. And those people grew the faith. Then those people were trying to imitate Christ in the same way that the apostles did. And sure enough, more faithful. So that's what we are called to do today. That same message. How well can we imitate Christ? And it's something that we do see folks doing every single day. I was at a funeral this week where I heard this beautiful homily about a lady that had been on a journey where she'd been thinking about the Catholic Church for many years. She'd gone to a Catholic school and she was playing in grade school. And it had touched her in some way. But now, as she became ill and she was starting to, you know, go into the decline, a Catholic friend touched her in some way. And through that touch, that lady was baptized and brought into the church several months before her death. I mean, just a beautiful story. And the person that did that really didn't think they were doing much. They just said, well, you know, I was there, I was talking to them, and they mentioned that, and I just kind of spent some time talking to them. So that may be all that we were called to do, just listen and kind of guide. So as we leave this Mass today, I think that's what I'd like for us all to kind of meditate on, is love our neighbor as ourselves, but how do we do that in a way that brings God forward to them, and in some way brings them on their journey to God, where they will have that same life and eternity with all of us.
Jesus taught us, we come to God with confidence, bringing our concerns for the church and for the world.
For pastoral leaders and preachers, for dedicated liturgists and educators. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For patient peacemakers and negotiators, for compassionate leaders and honest lawmakers. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For widows and orphans, for the abused and the abandoned. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this parish, that God will grant answers to all of our prayers and needs. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lead the departed into the light of your dwelling place, that they may gaze upon you for all eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions listed in our parish book of prayer, and for all of the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Living God and true God, you are our strength and our refuge. Hear the prayers of your people, which we make through Christ.